Cash flow analysis in marketing projects helps advertisers optimize budget allocation by identifying profitable and underperforming campaigns. In this video, we'll create and share a dynamic template in Excel with four easy steps: calculating project outflows, inflows, and net flow, drawing cash flow diagrams and decision making, differentiating cash flow, net present value or NPV, and internal rate of return or IRR, and cash flow forecasting in advertising projects and affiliate marketing. You can follow along by getting the Excel workbook by the provided link in the description below.
Stefan is calculating project outflows, inflows, and net flows.
We'll use a case project of cost per action or CPA advertising, which is a digital marketing model where advertisers pay for a specific action such as a purchase or user registration. Let's consider a 5-week advertising period and analyze outflows, inflows, and net flows on a weekly basis. The advertiser is using 5 platforms including Google, Meta and its Facebook and Instagram, X, which was previously called Twitter, Pinterest, and Reddit. Let's start by defining expenses or outflows. This is cash spent and shown by negative values. The total outflow for week 1 is calculated by summing up the expenditure across the 6 platforms. The cumulative column shows the running total, which is equal to total outflow or minus $6,000 in week 1. We have the same amount of cash spent in week 2. Cumulative outflow can be found by summing up the previous week's figure and total outflow of the current week. We can duplicate the values and define the cash spent in week 3 to 5. Now we can calculate cumulative outflow, and by week 6 we reach minus $30,000, which is also the total budget for our CPA advertising campaign. In week 6, no cash is spent, which means the ad campaign has ended and the cumulative outflow figure remains unchanged. Now let's focus on inflows or revenue from conversions. Inflows usually lag behind ad spending and there is a delay. This is 1 week of lag for Google and Meta as shown in the values. In week 6, there is no spending, but revenue is still coming in, which is from the ad spend from the previous weeks. That's important because it shows the campaign continues to generate revenue 1 week after it's officially finished. The lag period for X is 2 weeks and the first inflows appear in week 3. The delay affects when the revenue comes in, and we have the inflow values for Pinterest and Reddit, which have lag periods of 1 and 2 weeks respectively. Total and cumulative inflows are calculated in a similar way we did before in column G and H. Finally, we should focus on the net flow, which is the sum of total outflow and inflow. The formula for week 1 is then replicated for the following weeks. In week 1, there is no inflow or revenue and we have a net flow of minus $6,000. In weeks 2 and 3, inflows begin to arrive, so the net flow gradually improves. Week 4 inflows hit $6,000, which balances out the outflow, and we have a net flow of $0. Then in week 5, net flow further improves. Finally, in week 6, we observe a significant positive net flow of $8,100, which proves that after the campaign ends, revenue continues to come in.
Step 2 is drawing cash flow diagrams and decision making.
In this step, select the 3 columns of cumulative outflow, cumulative inflow, and net flow by holding the Ctrl key. Then navigate to the Insert tab and select the combo chart. The chart type for outflow and inflow will be clustered column, and net flow is animated using a line graph. Feel free to change this to line with markers for a better visualization. Unwanted elements of the combo chart can be removed, and we should change color of data series to suit our project reports. We have decided to show inflows in green and outflow in orange. The net flow line and markers have a solid black color for clarity. This is an information-rich cash flow chart, and the key here is to identify trends and insights that aren't immediately obvious. Let's start by looking into delayed profitability in our advertising project. Marketing campaigns, and especially cost per action or CPA, often require significant upfront investment before generating positive returns. In this example, the net cash flow only turns positive in week 5 and series in week 6 after ad spending has already stopped. This delay occurs because conversions in performance marketing rarely happen instantly. This means platforms have different attribution windows and users may take time to complete actions such as signing up or making a purchase. Advertisers must account for this lag when evaluating campaign performance, as prematurely ending a campaign could result in missing out on later stage conversions that significantly impact profitability. Budgeting and cash flow planning should extend beyond the active ad spend period of 5 weeks to accommodate these delayed returns. Now let's shift focus on platform-specific conversion lag times. Not all advertising platforms generate revenue at the same speed. In this campaign, Google and Meta start producing inflows as early as week 2, which reflects their relatively short conversion cycles. On the other hand, X and Reddit see their first meaningful revenue in week 3. This variation shows the importance of understanding each platform's typical attribution window. Advertisers should structure their budgets to balance immediate return platforms, such as Google and Meta, with the slower but high-value channels, including Reddit and X. A well-optimized mix ensures a steady cash flow rather than relying solely on fast-converting traffic, which may have higher competition and cost. The next important observation is about break-even point and cash flow timing. While the campaign eventually breaks even by reaching $30,000 cumulative inflows by week 6, the timing of cash flows is crucial. The first 4 weeks see a cumulative outflow of -$24,000, which means the advertiser must have sufficient liquidity to sustain operations before inflows catch up. Businesses must ensure they have the working capital to bridge this gap, especially in longer or higher budget campaigns. May I pause here for a minute and quickly mention something? Our analytics show that only around 40% of the channel's regular viewers are subscribed. If you are enjoying our content, don't forget to subscribe and turn on the notification bell. It's a free way to support us in continuing this learning journey. Thanks. Returning to our cash flow analysis, the next point to focus on is working capital or liquidity management. The early weeks of this campaign demonstrate a steep cash outflow before inflows begin to balance the scales. Many businesses underestimate the working capital required to sustain such periods of negative cash flow. Advertisers must either secure sufficient reserves or structure payment terms with vendors to align with expected revenue delays. Also, staggering platform spending and reducing initial outlays on laggy channels like Reddit will help smooth cash flow without sacrificing long-term returns. The next managerial inference is focused on post-campaign value of long-tail platforms. As you can see, Reddit and X show a long-tail effect where a significant portion of conversions occur after campaigns end. In this case, Reddit generates 30% of its total inflow, which is $450 out of $1,500 in week 6. Also, X earns 33% of its revenue post-campaign. These delayed inflows effectively act as free profit since they require no additional ad spend. By animating the cash flows, we have created a decision-making tool. This is also an important concept in the Project Management Professional or PMP certification exams by PMI. By implementing cash flow analysis, project managers can plan for potential delays and ensure sufficient liquidity to cover any early negative cash flows.
Step 3 is differentiating cash flow, net present value, and internal rate of return.
Cash flow is the movement of money in and out of your project over time. Think of it as tracking every dollar spent and every dollar earned. In project management, we typically analyze cash flow over specific periods such as months or weeks. Understanding cash flow is foundational because it tells you when you'll need funds and when you can expect returns. Managing cash flow effectively means ensuring you have enough liquidity to cover expenses at each stage of the project. Poor cash flow management can lead to project delays, cost overruns, and even project failure. Now let's move to net present value or NPV. This takes cash flow a step further by considering the time value of money. This concept acknowledges that a dollar today is worth more than a dollar in the future. NPV discounts future cash flows back to their present value using a discount rate that reflects the project's risk and the opportunity cost of capital. A positive NPV shows that the project is expected to add value to the company. For instance, if you are evaluating a new advertising project with high upfront costs and long-term returns, NPV helps you assess whether those future returns justify the initial investment. NPV is a powerful tool for comparing different projects and making informed investment decisions. Finally, let's talk about the internal rate of return or IRR. This is a discount rate that makes the NPV of a project equal to zero. Unlike NPV, which gives you a dollar value, IRR gives you a percentage. If the IRR is higher than the company's cost of capital, the project is generally considered acceptable. IRR is especially useful for comparing projects with different investment sizes and timelines. For example, if you're choosing between two marketing platforms with similar NPV, the one with the higher IRR is more attractive because it offers a greater return on investment. So let's recap. Cash flow focuses on the timing and amount of money moving in and out of the project. NPV calculates the present value of future cash flows and provides a measure of the project's value creation. IRR determines the project's rate of return and offers a relative measure of profitability.
Step 4 is cash flow forecasting in advertising projects and affiliate marketing.
We first focus on Google Ads. Here you need to estimate your cost per click or CPC and conversion rates accurately. Start by analyzing historical data. Remember, Google's algorithm is a beast. It learns and adapts, so your forecast need to be dynamic. The initial cost, including account setup, keyword research tools, and landing page development should be factored in. Be aware of payout delays from affiliate networks, which can impact your cash inflow. And always include a contingency buffer to absorb unexpected CPC increases or algorithm changes. Meta is the next point of focus. Facebook and Instagram offer powerful targeting, but they also require careful cash flow management. You need to forecast based on your audience demographics, ad placements, and campaign objectives. The creative production costs, especially for high-quality visuals, can significantly impact upfront expenses. Plan for ad fatigue by budgeting for regular creative refreshes to maintain performance. Regular monitoring and adjustments are crucial for maintaining a healthy cash flow. Now, X or Twitter present a unique challenge. Its fast-paced and real-time nature means your campaigns need to be agile. Here, you're dealing with trends that can shift in hours, not days. Capitalizing on trending hashtags can drive traffic, but requires rapid spending adjustments. High engagement rates can lower costs, but require active community management. Partnering with influencers can be expensive but highly effective. Be prepared for sudden cost changes due to real-time bidding fluctuations. It is all about immediacy. Pinterest, with its visual search focus, requires a different approach. Here you're dealing with long-term engagement and purchase intent. Your cash flow forecast needs to account for the time it takes for pins to gain traction and convert. High-quality pins are essential for visual content creation. Optimizing for relevant keywords is crucial for being discovered. Pins can drive traffic for months and impact long-term revenue. Your cash flow forecast needs to reflect this with a focus on sustained investment and patient monitoring. Reddit, with its niche communities and unique culture, demands a highly targeted and authentic approach. Cash flow forecasting here requires a deep understanding of each subreddit's dynamics. Costs vary significantly between subreddits. Here, authentic engagement is crucial for positive reception. Plan for potential backlash and its impact on your cash flow, including downvotes and negative feedback. Reddit users respond well to specific and relevant products. Today, we have journeyed through the cash flow statement in projects. This can help you manage and forecast your cash flow more effectively, and your project remains financially healthy.
If you found this video useful, please consider subscribing. You can get the Excel workbook via the provided link in the description below. I'll see you in the next one.